Very nice. How long have you been here?
3 months.
That's been going on for 30 years. That's good. You have a nice feel for it. I think what I would probably say, I mean, I'm so curious. He wrote these in the early 1830s. And I just wonder, I think Chopin's Barcarolle Opus 60 is F sharp major, but written later. I wonder if he was inspired by this. Especially with the thirds he brings in. I think if you did almost everything that you do, slower. A little slower, not too much. But just instead of going 60 miles an hour, go 50. I think that'll kind of align everything without feeling like you have to push it for the line. Again, same question. Do you sing out loud when you practice? Occasionally. Okay, because you're not going to sing this song, but I want to. I think you do too. I think you almost want to do what you think you want to do, but you're not sure how to do it. I think the thing is to just say, and I take a deep breath and play it. I think if I just actually conducted you, a lot of it would come out very naturally. Don't feel like you have to say you're not an actor. Don't feel like you have to rush it to keep the line or to make it expressive. Sometimes the line is better when you stretch it. As long as it doesn't get vertical, just Tom, one more breath. I think you could do more with that. The other one that you're gonna play again, I'm just gonna keep your pulse, I'm gonna be your orchestra a little.
Don't play too soft in the beginning. One, two, it's like a bar roll, actually, just the book song. One and two.
Make does that sound like it? Finish when you play. You play a long note, relax your arm after. You know, I've seen people like shake their heads. I think they're getting vibrato Actually, it's what you do after in your mind, after a long note, is the sound you're going to get. If you hear the thing going down, it's going to go bump. If you think out of it, always get out of your own way. You know, that's like the conductors would say to me, I have to get out of the way. You have to get out of the way. You know, there's players are like, they just want you to be a traffic cop. Get out of the way. The less you do, the better. The less you do, the better. Don't try to do too much. But when you play along with it, I notice you just stop and you stay stiff. And that's so dangerous over time. The idea is to keep muscles moving free. Never be stiff, just keep it free. And once you play that long note and you know you're going to be free, it's going to free the sound. It does. The sound, the speed of the hammer is not as fast when you play it like that. If you go down too quickly and stay, the hammer's going to go up. And the sound's going to go up. It's going to go to them and not there. So it's a matter of just understanding the sound and how you produce it and what you do mostly after. Okay? Just like, it's like rowing, you know? You're always thinking, moving the line ahead, rowing the boat. You row, but you're rowing the boat to get ahead. So you're playing to get ahead. So that's already much better, okay? There's other ones that you should play, the G minor one. Play a lot of Chopin. Good, and the dynamics are good. It's singing, it's flowing better with this pulse. Never feel that you need to rush to, because you can't hold the line, you can hold the line. And if you sing out loud, you will hold the line. It forces you not to rush, because your fingers will follow your voice. Okay.